Hello students, welcome to my channel. This is Vasanth Naik from Canara Engineering College. Today we will discuss one more concept or one more method to solve Boolean expression that is called as a Petrick method. So Petrick's method. So we know any Boolean expression can be solved by using four methods. First one is Boolean theorems. That is, first one is Boolean theorem. Boolean theorem and rules. That is the first one. Second one is we have K-map. In K-map, we have two methods. One is POSOP, sum of product. Second one is POS. Third one is EVM. So third method is Q-map, or it is also called as a tabular method. We know what is the advantage of K-map over Boolean theorem and rules. What is the advantage of Q-map over K-map? For example, if I want to say the advantage of Q-map over K-map, K-map depends on user ability to group, and it becomes complicated when number of variable increases. K-map will be fine for four to five variables. When the number of variable increases, K-map will become very cumbersome. In order to overcome that, we have Q-map. But the disadvantage of Q-map is when the number of variable increases in Q-map, the prime implicant chart becomes complicated, and it will become difficult to determine the essential prime implicants from a prime implicant chart. So we will see this one with example. So here you can see a function of three variable with the minterms 0, 1, 2, 5, 6, 7, and we know how to solve this one by using Q-map. I will not discuss here how to solve this problem by using Q-map. For that, please refer my earlier video, Q-map. So we'll see the next stage of this problem, that is prime implicant charts. This is prime implicant chart. You can see here all these are prime implicants, and all these are minterms. Like prime implicants represented vertically and minterms are represented horizontally. For example, minterm 0 is covered by prime implicant A bar, B bar and A bar, C bar. Similarly, minterm 1 is covered by this prime implicant and this prime implicant. Now, if you see this one, this prime implicant chart doesn't have any one column with the single cross symbol. If any one of the column contains single X symbol, then that prime implicant is known as essential prime implicants. That means that prime implicant, you have to add that in your expression. You cannot eliminate that prime implicant. But if you see this chart, for example, minterm 0 is covered by two prime implicants, like this and this. Minterm 1 is covered by two prime implicants. So in this case, it is very difficult to determine prime implicant, essential prime implicants from this one. So in order to determine the essential prime implicants from this chart, we will use Petrick method. In Petrick method, we use variables P1, P2, P3, P4, P5, P6 to represent rows or to represent prime implicants. For example, P1 is used to represent A bar, B bar. P2 is used to represent A bar, C bar. P3 is represent B bar, C. P4 is represent B bar, C bar. P5 represent AC. P6 represent AB. And other than that, horizontally, as I said earlier, these are the minterms 0, 1, 2, 5, 6, 7 of our problem statement. Now, we'll proceed further and how to determine the essential prime implicants from this, we'll see. So, let me repeat once again. Patrick method is a technique. It is used to determine essential prime implicants from the prime implicant chart. So, in this diagram or in this table, we have several prime implicants here. And from this, we have to determine the essential prime implicants, which is the best minimal SOP solution. SOP solution for the particular problem statement. So, in this chart, as I said, we have taken different variables and all those variables are P1, P2, P3, P4, P5, P6 which represent prime implicants, and all those prime implicants are marked here vertically as shown, and minterms are marked here horizontally as shown. Now, we need to write one function. We need to write the function P that is true in such a way that it should include all the minterms. So we need to write a function P which is true or 1 in such a way that it should include all the minterms. For example, to include minterm 0, I need to consider prime implicant P1 labeled as P1 or P2. To include minterm 0, I need to consider prime implicant P1 or P2. I can write something like this. To include minterm 1, I need to select prime implicant P1 or P3. Similarly, to include minterm 2, I need to consider P2 plus P4. In order to include 5, I have to consider P3 plus P6. In order to include 7, I have to consider P5 and P6. So, we need to consider all these terms. If all these terms are, all these terms are high, then the P1 will be high. So, let us see now the expression. So, here you can see the expression P is I when all these terms are, that is P1 plus P2 is I, or P1 plus P3 is I, or P2 plus P4 is I, or P3 plus P5 is I, etc. Now, we have to solve this one by using distributive law. What is the distributive law? Distributive law is something x plus z is equal to x plus yz. We know from distributive law x plus y into x plus z is equal to x plus yz. So, by using distributive law, we have to simplify this one. For example, here, if you take this is x, this is y, and this is x, and this is z, then by seeing this one distributive law, this is x, p1 is x, p2 and p3 are yz. Then you can write this one as P1 plus P2 P3. P2 P3. So now we have covered this and this term. Now you take P2 plus P4 and P4 plus P6. And in this case, this is X and P2 and P6 are YZ. Then this becomes P4 plus P2 into P6. Then remaining one is now this and this, where P5 is the common, P5 and P6 plus P6 into P3. So now we got this expression. Now you have to multiply this one and you have to further simplify by using eliminating redundant terms by using the formula, that is x plus xy is equal to x. So first you have to multiply this one, then you have to eliminate the redundant term. After multiplying this one, you have to eliminate the redundant term by using this formula. How to multiply? Multiplying is a very easy process here. You have to multiply this term with this term, this term with this term, this term with this term, and this term with this term. Finally, whatever the answer you get, for that you have to multiply with this one. So let us see this in the next step. As I explained when we proceed to the next step, first you have to multiply these products. When you multiply these product terms, you will get this expression. This expression you have to simplify further by eliminating the redundant term by using Boolean theorem, x plus xy is equal to x. Now, when you use this, apply this theorem, you cannot simplify this term further. You cannot simplify this term further. You cannot simplify this term further. But if you take P2, P3, P6 and P1, P2, P3, P6. Let me write here. That is P2, P3, P6 and P1, P2, P3, P6. And P2, P3, 6. Let me consider this is X. Then P1 is Y. Then anyway, P2, 3, 6, X. Then it will, according to theorem, it will get simplified to X. That means I will get, I am going to get P2, P3, P6. So that means this term will get eliminated. And this term remains. Now, same term, P2, P3, P6, and this one will combine now. That time, P4 acts like a Y here, variable Y, and this term also will get cancelled, and this leads to only this term, P2, 3, 6. Now, P2, 3, 6, we will consider with the P2, 3, 5, 6. Here you can see P5 acts like Y, and once again this term will get eliminated. This term will get eliminated, this term anyway eliminated, this term is eliminated. And remaining term is P2, P3, P6. That means we have 5 terms are remaining. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. That cannot be further simplified by using this theorem. This law. Now we will proceed to next step. So this is the final expression we got. Our function P is equal to 1. When any one of this term is equal to 1. That means all these terms are the solution for our problem statement. But you have to select those terms which has got minimum rows. Here you see this term has got 4 rows, this term has got 4 rows, this term has got 4 rows. But we have 2 terms which has got only 3 rows. So here our solution is P1, P4, P5 or there are 2 solutions for this problem, P2, P3 and P6. One is P1, P4, P5. P5 or P2, P3, P6. We'll see that one, which is that term now. So, according to solution, we have two terms. One is P1, P4, P5. That is, P1 is A bar, B bar, plus P4 is B, C bar, plus P5 is AC. That is the one solution for this problem. Otherwise, we have one more solution. Let me write here only. One more solution is P2, P3 and P6. What is P2, P3, P6 from this one? P2 is A bar, C bar. P3 is B bar, C. Plus P6 is AB. So, these are the two solutions we found out from using Petrick method. This method has an advantage of selecting essential prime implicants compared to our QMAP method. In QMAP method, we have problem of selecting essential prime implicants when number of variables are very high. Thank you.